In this video, we are going to talk about some of the very important options of Koha, which is available in the tools. Just click on tools and you will be taken inside the page where you will get the different option. There are three categories given here, that is the pattern and circulation, the second one is catalog, and the third one is additional tool. In fact, here we will discuss one by one, in which I'll be discussing the first one, which is very important to know about the notices and slip. Actually, these notices we can define to send the or the print the email notification messages for the different type of our requirement, like overdues and other things. So to in the pattern and circulation category, you can find the first one is pattern list, comments, import patterns, notices and slips. So we will not discuss other, we will discuss straight away the notices and slips. Just click on notices and slips here. So you will find that there are already many notices defined in the system. Okay, I'll show you one by one. See, there are many. I'll take one and I'll show you how you can define the notice or slip to be sent either through mail or to print the information according to your notice. So to check in, the code we have given check in, you just click on edit. I'll just show you how it has been defined. You can see the template. The name of the library you have to select first, and the Koha module for which you are generating, definitely the circulation you are generating, and the code, the name of the particular the notice, and what would be the subject when you are sending the information to the particular user. And here this is the message body where you have to define the text. So the text has already been defined. The following item have been checked in, and the what, the biblio title. This will display the title from where you get this information. Left side, if you see, there are many options given. Accordingly, you can select. If you want to add any, you can add biblio author, and just face right side, so it will display the information about title and author when the item is checked in the library. Now we'll take another one. If you want to save it, you just submit it. We'll take another one. For example, issue slip. When any user issues any document from the library, so how it generates the issue slip, you can see here. I'll come straight away to the message body. First, it is displaying the branches dot branch name, then checked out to whom, borrower title, then borrower first name and the borrower initial and the borrower surname. Finally, it is showing here borrower card number below the surname. Then today checked out, message is displayed here, checked out, checkout, and the biblio title, the title of the book with barcode number and due date, when is the due date for returning the document. So this is the message body, and below that overdue, the information, all this is displayed. So in this way you can also define the text for any particular slip or the notice which you are generating using the notices and slip option. Let us take the new notice which you are going to generate. See, here you can define the code, and first you need to select the Koha module for which you are generating. For example, claim acquisition. Suppose you have placed the order for any book and the document has not it been received by the library. I'll just give the code CACQ, so it will be easy for us to remember. Claim acquisition, and claim for acquisition. Okay. Now message subject. Simply I'll just give claim for the title not received. Okay, this is the text which you have given for the message subject, and now here you can define your own code accordingly. Dear vendor, the following document has not yet been received, kindly supply. For it depends on you how you are going to keep the information about the text. Okay, so we will take the code from here. Definitely you are going to send the information to the bookseller, so first you need to take the name of the bookseller. Definitely you will take the name, then address, second address if any, and then phone number, then account number if any. Account number is not required, so you can leave it. And the bookseller contact, you can enter the whatever the information you would like to have, you can take it accordingly from here. And then the order detail you would like to have in your notices, so you can generate, take the acquisition order number, and you can take the information about other thing. I'll just go up and see what information we can take from here. Okay, so we can take means as per our requirement. If you want acquisition book seller note, if this we have already selected, and now we are going to select about the order. So the biblio number and all, whatever you want, you can take the information, means the code accordingly, and bring it to the right side, and then finally submit it. So when you are generating the claim for the acquisition, so you can select the particular claim which you have generated for your library for sending the claim for the acquisition. You can see we have defined here. Actually there is already defined acquisition claim, that body also you can see here, the acquisition bookseller name, address, then all the details here, then order number, acquisition order number, then biblio title, it has already been defined, acquisition quantity ordered, and has not been received. So this way also you can define the order, the notice to be sent to the particular vendor to claim the title which you have not received. So in this way we can generate the many notices for sending the mails to the user as well as to the different people or users of the library for different purposes. So this was all about how you can generate the notices and slip for your requirement.